Hammer curls. Probably the best arm curl for your forearms and your brachialis muscles. It also works your long head in a way, but the primary muscles are your brachialis and your forearms. Now, a lot of people, when they do these, they're going to bring their arm straight up to their shoulder. I tend to think that's a waste of time. I think it's more effective to bring the arm into the chest and back down. You can do one arm at a time. Throwing them together like this puts in a little bit too much of a wave with your body. It's a little more stable when you do one at a time and really focus on it. So alternating hammer curls. Probably better to do them towards the end so you still have good grip strength throughout your bicep workout. Hammer curls. What we're about to do is a high pulley bicep curl. It's a finishing movement you use at the end of your workout for biceps that helps bring the height or the peak of your bicep out. It's just like doing a front double bicep, but now you're doing like an exercise motion with it. You're going to use a lighter weight than normal. Forms everything on this one. It's a shaper exercise, so you're doing higher reps. It's not a mass builder. It's just a shaper high peak builder. When you do it, you want to keep your elbows to your outside. You don't want your elbows to creep in. Keep them on the outside, keep your chest out. And when you bring in when you're curling in, keep your elbows in alignment. Don't let them come up and don't let them come out. You're going to want to as you get tired and fatigued. Your back's going to want to jump in there and help it out, but try not to. And once again, this works the height of the biceps, giving you that high peak. Make sure your range of motion goes all the way out like this. Otherwise, you're going to end up with a shorter head bicep.